Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about my conclusion to my Project Pan Use 3x1 for the year 2015. So if you guys have not been following me and my Project Pan updates for the year 2015, the links are in the bottom bar if you want to check out my progress over this past year. Basically, what the concept of this particular project was that I would use up 3 products in one category, and then I would be allowed to purchase 1 product of that in that category once I finished 3 products. So for example, if I finished 3 face powders, then I would be allowed to go and purchase 1 face powder wherever I wanted to purchase it. So if I used up 3 body creams, I would be able to allow myself 1 purchase of a body cream. You know, if I use 3 foundations, I can go and purchase a foundation. So kind of that's what the concept is, pretty much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through my list of all the stuff I used up with you guys. And whatever items I didn't finish, I will probably push those products into 2016, which I will do a completely different video for 2016 Project Pan. So today, I guess we can say this would be my conclusion for Project Pan 2015. Okay, so I'm gonna dive right in. If you guys have any questions, you know what to do, leave them in the bottom bar. And like this video if you guys want to see my 2016 Project Pan journey, because I definitely do want to start that in January. I'm just gonna go through each category of products, and I'm gonna tell you how many products in the year that I've used up, and if I purchased any products to replace those ones I've used. Or I'm gonna try and make this as quick as possible. So first up, I'm going to go with face cleansers and scrubs. It's funny because I had to... Okay, here we go. So face cleansers and scrubs, I finished quite a couple, actually. I finished the Michael Todd Oat and Honey, the Avani Dead Sea Deep Cleansing Mud Facial Gel, and the Freeman's Pink Grapefruit Scrub. And once I finished those, I wanted to buy the Glam Glow Super Mud Cleansing. Is it cleansing? Yeah, the cleansing, like the cleanser. However, funny enough, I tried the Glam Glow Super Mud in a deluxe sample size, and I wasn't really a fan of it. So I did not end up purchasing a cleanser to replace. So I actually finished a lot more this year in cleansers, because those were the top 3 that I wanted to make sure I finished from the start of my project. I did finish a couple more, but I did not add them to this list because they weren't really on my list to finish, but they did get finished. So I think in total, I think I maybe have finished maybe 6 to 7 cleansers this year, and I have not repurchased. So I'm still downsizing my cleansers for face wash. I still have quite a few, so I'm probably not going to buy a cleanser anytime soon. Moving on. Face masks. So I do have quite a few face masks. I have quite a bit, actually, like too much for one person, I personally think. So I did finish 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I finished 7 face masks. 8. Sorry, I lied. 8 face masks this year. And the whole purpose of this project was, after finishing 3 face masks, I was going to buy 1 product in that category. So I ended up extending it. I finished about 8 face masks, and I only bought 1 face mask to replace those 8, and that was the Boscia Tsubaki Deep Hydrating Mask. So I did actually really, really well. The face mask that I finished was my Lush Mask of Magna Minty, the Body Shop Tea Tree Mask, the Proactive Refining Mask, the QH Avocado Grapefruit Mask, oh, the Queen Helen Avocado Grapefruit Mask, the Glam Glow, the Black Glam Glow Deluxe Mask, like, you know how there's the full size of the Glam Glow and then there's like the travel size? I finished the travel size of the Black Glam Glow Mask, the Queen Helen Olive Oil Mask I finished as well, and the Glam Glow Green Deluxe Mask, which I was not, was I a fan of? No, I actually did like the green one. The green one was good. Where are my other masks now? And then I also finished the Origins Out of Trouble Mask. In my round two of face masks, I still had the Origins charcoal mask and the Ren glycolic lactic mask that I have to finish. So I still have to finish two more. But those two I'm going to push into the new year because I did finish 8 masks this year and I'm actually pretty proud of myself. And to replace those 8 masks, I did purchase the Tsubaki hydrating mask by Bosha because it is such a fabulous mask. It's $42 Canadian at Sephora. Fabulous hydrating mask. I cannot describe to you how amazing it is. You can put it on at night and sleep with it on. Excuse me, in the morning, your skin is so plump and refreshed that I have no words. So I did repurchase a mask after I finished those 8. So, you know, that's pretty good because my rule of thumb for this project pan was use 3 by 1. But I have been stretching it out quite a bit and, you know, waiting to finish more products instead of just 3. So, you know, I'm pretty proud of myself for that. So next up is body lotion. The body lotion I wanted to... You guys, I have so much body lotion, like it is so ridiculous. I think I need to do an inventory of all my makeup and my beauty stuff and kind of give you an idea of how much crap I really have. It is really ridiculous. So the body lotion, I was going to use up 3 and then purchase the Josie Maran Whipped Argan Oil Body Butter, and that's $43 at Sephora. The body butter is freaking amazing. I had I don't know if it was a sample size. Yes, it was a sample size from Sephora with that body butter, and I fell in love with the scent. I fell in love with the texture. I fell in love with how it hydrated my body. So that is on my wish list. However, I have finished, how many did I finish? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I finished 12 body creams this year, and I still have not purchased a body lotion. I have not purchased the Josie Maran body lotion, and I have not purchased any body lotion in the year of 2015. I didn't purchase any. Like, I'm so seriously honest with you guys. I was so proud of myself that I did not purchase any. Why? Being the fact that I had so many, I didn't need to use them. I didn't need to buy more, is what I'm trying to say. So, I'm kind of wanting to finish a few more body lotions before I invest in this $40 body butter, because I can't justify going to get the body butter until I bring down my lotion stash a little bit more. So that's going to be moved into 2016. So after the body lotion, I had face powders and bronzers were in one category. I did finish 3 powders. I finished the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. I finished the MAC Bronzer Stick Cream. The reason why I included the bronzer cream stick by MAC is because it was a bronzer and I wanted to include face powders and bronzers together. And I also finished the MAC Bronzer and Refined Golden. So those 3 I finished. And I was going to get the Makeup Forever HD Press Powder because I've tried it and I absolutely fell in love with it. But I am holding off. I'm currently working on finishing the MAC Studio Fix NC42 face powder. So, to be honest, you guys, I don't want to go and get the Makeup Forever face powder until I finish the MAC Studio Fix one, because the MAC Studio Fix one is a full coverage foundation powder. So it does... you can wear it like on top of a liquid foundation. You could also wear it alone. But I just find that I don't need to spend that much money on a face powder until I finish the one that I have, that I've been using. So I think that will pull me into 2016, pretty much most of 2016, because the MAC Studio face powders are quite, generous in product size. So I'm actually really proud of myself for that as well. I have not purchased a face powder in 2015, or a bronzer. Have I purchased a bronzer? Nope, haven't even purchased a bronzer. So I am really, really proud of myself that I did not do that. So BB creams. BB creams I kind of lacked a little bit this year. I only finished the Garnier BB cream. The Garnier BB cream. Funny enough is that I still need to finish my MAC BB cream in the compact and my L'Oreal BB cream, which I'm almost done. I don't think I'll finish in 2015. I'll probably finish it in early 2016. But those two I need to finish. And I'd like to purchase the Tarte BB cream because I've heard so many good things about the Tarte BB cream. So that is my goal. Once I finish the MAC and the L'Oreal BB creams, I will definitely pick up the Tarte, probably in the new year. But, you know, I still finished 1 BB cream this year, and I'm actually pretty proud of myself, because when you finish those type of products, you feel like you're actually getting your money's worth, if you guys know what I'm saying. If you guys get the drift. So, Oh, I lied, you guys. The face cleansers that I also finished, because I only told you three. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I actually finished 8 cleansers this year. So I also finished my Jo Fresh cleanser, the St. Ives Tea Tree cleanser, the L'Oreal Deep Cleansing 380 Degree cleanser, the L'Oreal Acne cleanser, and the Garnier Cream cleanser. So instead of 3, I actually finished 8 cleansers, and I'm still powering through. And like I said, I wanted to get the Glam Glow Super Mud Clearing Treatment cleanser, but I kind of changed my mind when I tried the sample size. So I haven't decided what is my next cleanser going to be, but I want to bring my cleanser stash a bit more down before I make a decision on what next cleanser I will be using or purchasing. So concealer. I do have a list. I have a long list of concealers. Okay, so concealers, I have finished 4 concealers. Yes, 4 concealers. So I finished the CoverGirl and Olay concealer, the Maybelline Luminizer concealer, the Physician's Formula concealer ball, and the Maybelline Age Rewind concealer. So that was 4 concealers, and what I really wanted to purchase was the Tarte Creaseless Concealer, which I have not purchased, just so you guys know. I kind of want to finish a few more concealers because I have quite a few concealers in my stash that I don't need that many concealers. So I'm not going to be purchasing a concealer until I bring down my stash a bit more. I do have some really great concealers in my stash right now. I have high-end and I have drugstore. So I'm going to try and focus on getting those down as well next year. But I did do a little bit of a dent this year with the ones I finished. So I'm actually pretty satisfied with that. So eye primers. I finished 2 this year. Eye primers are a little bit harder to kind of go through because you only need a little amount of product to place on your lids. So I finished the Urban Decay Primer, the anti-aging. I didn't really notice a difference with the anti-aging primer. It did what any primer does. It just kind of helps with the creases in your eyelids for shadow. But I still have 2 more primers that I would like to finish before I make a purchase of another primer. So the first one is, I'm currently working on the Lorac Eyeshadow Primer and the MAC Paint Pot and Paint Relief. So, you know, I'm going to see how that goes. I'm going to, you know, work on that for next year and then go from there. So foundations. Foundations is also really hard to work through in the year because foundations are, you don't need a lot of foundation on your face to do your makeup. So sometimes, you know, it does take you a longer period of time to get through a foundation. I am proud to say that I have finished 3 foundations in the year of 2015. I finished the CoverGirl Whipped Cream Foundation, the Kat Von D Locket Tattoo Foundation, and the CoverGirl 3-in-1 Foundation. I am pretty proud of myself for finishing 3 foundations in 1 year. I was going to purchase the NARS Sheer Glow as my next foundation. But looking at my foundation stash, I really want to bring down my stash, I guess you could say, of foundations, and then I will decide on purchasing another foundation. But for now, I'm not like antsy to go and buy another foundation. First of all, foundations are really expensive. They can range between $20 at the drugstore to, you know, $70, $80 high end. So they're very expensive. For now, I think I'm satisfied with my foundation stash. I am going to be bringing it much further down before I go and pick up another foundation. I have a couple of foundations on my wish list, but I would really love to clear out quite a few more products in my foundation stash before I go and invest in those particular foundations, because the ones that I want are a little bit more on the higher end side. So lip glosses, I finished 3 lip glosses this year, my MAC, Richer Lusher, my MAC On The Scene, and my MAC Lip Gloss of Lots Of Laughs. All of those I was able to get down to the very, very last quarter of the product before they turned and expired on me. So I did use them up to the best as I could. There was maybe just under a quarter of the product left. But once your lip glosses turn and you can smell that they've turned, you don't want to be putting those on your lips. So unfortunately, those had to go. But nonetheless, I did use, you know, a good 85% of them, maybe 90% of them. So I'm not really that heartbroken that I had to let them go when I did. they did the job, and I'm glad that they're out of my collection now. I'm not going to be purchasing any more lip glosses in the future, just because I'm not really a lip gloss fan. I'm more of a matte lipstick or like a lipstick type of girl, so glosses I'm trying to completely wipe out of my collection. If I do have a gloss, it'll be one or two for topper reasons, or even, to use on its own when I'm not wearing a lipstick. But as for like a wide range variety, I'm trying to bring that stash down. Lipsticks, I finished three, my MAC Hue, and then two Sephora lipsticks, and I did purchase a lipstick after I finished those three. I did purchase the NARS Audacious lipstick in the color Anna. I absolutely love the shade Anna, and it's so beautiful. The NARS Audacious lipsticks are quite expensive, so, you know, I did suck it up, and I did pick it up because I finished those three. My problem most of the time is I love liquid lipsticks, especially matte liquid lipsticks like what I'm wearing today. And that is my weakness when it comes to color makeup, I guess, or lip products, I guess you could say. So I do have a weakness for colored lip colors. I did purchase a couple of liquid lipsticks this year, but I like to rotate all my lip products. I like to use a whole bunch of them, not at the same time, but, you know, change it up every day. So all my lip products are getting love at the same time. They're not being wasted. So I really don't think that that's a huge issue. And I don't really think that my lipstick collection is as big as some other YouTubers I've seen here on YouTube, because mine is nowhere near that size. So I'm comfortable with my current collection size of lipsticks that I can handle. Nail polishes. I finished 4 nail polishes. Essie Bachelorette Bash, Butter London Trout Pout, China Glaze Diva Bride, and China Glaze Flip Flop Fantasy. I wiped out all 4 of those. They all were finished within this year, and I purchased the OPI Gel Shine polishes in replace of them. So they are the new OPI High Shine, I think they are, something like that. They come in a little bit of a smaller bottle than the regular nail polish, but since then I have not picked up any other nail polishes. I've been sticking to my current collection and just using what I have. So toner, I finished 2 toners, the Lush Tea Tree Toner and the Lush Aroma Water. They were both good. Right now I'm working on the Thayer's Lavender Toner, and that toner is really nice. What I did was I took the Thayer's Lavender Toner and put it in the Lush Tea Tree bottle that I had from my last, like, I'd finished the tea tree water. So I poured the Thayer's Lavender Toner in that bottle because the bottle has a nice spray and it comes out very misty, and I really do like that packaging. So I'm still working on the Thayer's toner, and I think once I finish that one, I will definitely repurchase another toner. I just don't know which one yet, because I don't have any backups of toners. Like, that particular category, I'm not very, I don't have backups at all on. So I'm just, you know, continuing on. When I run out of something, I'll go out and get it, type of thing. So, you know, slowly I'm getting there. Shampoo. So shampoo was a hard, hard thing this year to do. Why? Because I don't wash my hair every day. So it takes me longer to finish my products for hair related reasons. I finished the Fructus in the yellow bottle. It was like Fructus coconut oil something or other shampoo. I also finished my Red Light shampoo, which is the really extra large size. It was like the 1 liter size. And I finished my Macadamia shampoo. And I was going to invest in the Agave line of hair products, but I'm actually going to hold off because I have way too many products of shampoo and conditioner still that I just don't need to go and pick up the Agave line yet. So again, for conditioners and hair masks, I finished the L'Oreal Total Repair 5 hair mask, and I finished the Red Lights conditioner. That was the 1 liter bottle. So again, I haven't purchased any conditioners or hair masks this year. I've been just sticking to using what I have currently, and I'm going to continue doing that until my stash of hair products has kind of shrunk a little bit more. Okay, so hair products for after the shower. I finished my It's a 10 Leave-In conditioner. This was the smaller bottle. I finished the John Frieda Volume Booster Spray. I finished the Tresemme Heat Protectant. I finished the Bio 6 Silk Serum. I finished the High Shine Spray. And I also finished the Macadamia Leave-In Detangler. That's a total of 6 hair care products out of the shower. Have I purchased anything to replace it? No. I wanted to purchase something in the Agave line, but I didn't end up doing it. I'm going to actually hold off because I still have hair products for out of the shower that they need to be used up in order for me to go and purchase some more. So we're holding off on purchasing hair care products for now. Face creams. So I've finished quite a few. I finished 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I finished 7 face creams this year. The MAC Comfort Cream, the Clinique Eye Cream, the Michael Todd Moisture Light, the Aveeno Moisturizer, it's the Clear Improvements Moisturizer. Love that one, by the way. The Clean and Clear Gel, and the L'Oreal Texture Perfector for Day and Night, and the texture and the L'Oreal Texture Perfector in the Serum. And those were pretty good as well. Seven face creams. I did purchase, what did I purchase? So what I wanted was, if I was going to finish 3 face creams, I was going to invest in the Origins Energy Booster face cream, which is what I did. I waited until I finished those 7 though, instead of for the 3. So once I finished the 7, I ended up purchasing the Origins face cream by Origins, which was great. I'm still using it and I love it. And the funny thing is that my face creams stash is not as big as it was from last year. So now, because I've condensed my stash in face creams, I'm at that comfortable spot of, okay, I can handle this. I may have 1 or 2 backups, but that's it. This time last year for face creams, I must have had at least, close to almost 20 backups, close. The ones that I've told you that I finished here are only a portion. There were ones that I didn't include in this list that I did finish. So, I'm very proud of myself that I've brought it down quite a bit. I think maybe I have 3 backups now, but even with that, it's not a huge stash. So I'm actually comfortable with that size opposed to what I had before. What I had before was just too much. I did finish a few candles. I did finish 6 candles, but then I stopped keeping track of finishing candles because I really didn't do much I don't have a whole ton of candle backups. So I would have to say that I probably finished about, the ones I recorded, I finished 6, but I think I finished more than that. I'm pretty sure I'm more at the, I would say between 10 to 15 mark of candles being finished. I still have a couple left, probably a hand, maybe between 5 to 8 candles left. I would say 5 to 8, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, maybe 10, close to 10 candles left in my stash, but that is a lot smaller than what I had before. I think what I had before was maybe between 15 to 20. I don't remember. It was a lot. I didn't have any room to store them. They were just kind of lying around all over my room. Like, it was really, really, it was like hoarding, like, it just was not right. So I did bring it down quite a bit. Now the candles that I have are in a little box under my bed. When I finish a candle, I'll go in there and use the next one. I'm trying to bring down my candles to about 1 to 2 backups, only because I like to change out my candles for different seasons. So when winter finishes, well, right now I'm actually burning a summer candle, to be totally honest. Like, right now, currently, my Beach Cabana candle from Bath & Body Works is burning right now. And I love burning the summer candles in the wintertime because I'm a summer girl, so I hate winter. When winter is here, I just don't want to be reminded of it. So I like burning the summer candles. And the summer candles are my favorite scents. So realistically, I only really go for the spring summer candles, and I do like to pick up 1 or 2 fall candles in the fall season. But in the winter time, I'm not really a huge winter fan of those candle scents. So I just kind of like to use my summer candles, which is when I like to stock up on them. But what I'll probably do next year is probably buy like maybe 2 or 3, maybe 4 at the most, and kind of stretch that along for both seasons. So we'll see how that goes. But my candle stash is coming to a smaller portion. Face primers, I have finished 2 out of the 3. So I finished my Benefit Professional and I finished my L'Oreal Texture Perfector. I am currently working on my L'Oreal Miracle Blur, and it's what I'm wearing on my face today. I actually like it. It's not too bad at all. It does blur, so it does help blur bigger pores, which is great. Face primers, did I buy a face primer this year? I'm trying to remember. No, I did not buy a face primer this year. Face primers, again, take a lot of time to use. Why? Because you're using a little bit of the product for just, areas where you get oily. So just like your T-zone, basically. So, I haven't really I haven't really decided if I want it. Well, no, actually, I lied. There's two face primers I want. They're not really pore refining. They're more hydrating, which I think I will pick up in the year 2016. But I'm holding off a bit longer just so I can try and clear out some of my face primers. I don't have too many face primers. The current one I'm using is the Miracle Blur by L'Oreal. But aside from that, I think I have one or two face primers as backups, but that's about it. And I like to keep it at that size because I really don't need more than that. And like, let's be real. It's not like you're going to finish a face primer in like a month. Like, it takes a good amount of serious time to finish it. The Benefit Professional, I think, took me about eight to 10 months to finish. So we're gonna see now with the Miracle Blur on how long that's gonna take me, because I believe the Miracle Blur has more product than the Professional. So we'll see how that goes. Other than that, guys, that's pretty much what I finished up for 2015. I really do think that this was a great activity for me to do for my own self and my own self-improvement. A lot of you guys out there as YouTubers, beauty lovers, you know, you love all kinds of beauty products. I hear you when, you know, you've got so much stuff that you don't even know where to store it anymore, or you don't have the room to store it because you don't have that much space at home. I was pretty much there last year when I just looked at my stash of beauty products across all categories and said to myself, Antenna, you need to like bring this down, because there's no way you need all this crap when you're not even using it all at once. So I definitely brought a lot of it down in size. There were things, I did a lot of donating of products this year in the year 2015. There was a lot of drugstore palettes and a few high-end palettes that I did pass on to other folks that I know would probably enjoy it more than I would, because I have too many to begin with. So in the midst of me doing my Project Pan this year, I did donate a few beauty products to people that, put good use to them. And I'm glad that I was able to do that, because not many people can afford the amount of makeup that a lot of us invest in just because it's a hobby of ours. And that's what makeup is to me. It's a hobby of mine. I enjoy doing my makeup. It's kind of like a soothing ritual for me in a weird, crazy way to some people. I enjoy the process of putting it on. I enjoy the process of taking it off, as weird as that sounds. And I enjoy how makeup looks. Sometimes I like the packaging with the product. I think it's just a hobby, and sometimes the hobby can get a little expensive, like a little. And that was my problem. I was constantly investing in a lot of makeup that I couldn't use, that would probably go bad before I even got to it. And that's what brought me to start my Project Pan in the 2015 year. So I'm going to continue on to 2016. What I think I might do is I might change it up a bit, and I might list my categories of, you know, how many of each category I have. So how many lipsticks I have, how many lip liners, lip glosses, how many, you know, cream shadows, how many palettes, how many mascaras, how many eyeliners, you know, how many foundations, how many concealers. I'm going to do it by a category by category, and I'm going to list my inventory of makeup. And what I think I might do is, instead of going by what I finished, I'm going to just say, okay, well, this is what I had in the beginning of the year, and now this is the number at the end of the year. And then do it that way, because it's hard to track all the products you finish, especially when you're constantly using them. You know, once you use it, you throw it in your empties bag, and it gets moved on out of your collection. So I think for 2016, that's going to be my approach to it. I am noticing that I'm not purchasing as much makeup, since, like, in the sense that I see my collection of foundations and I don't want to buy any more at the moment until I finish a few. I have a weakness for makeup palettes. That is my weakness. I did buy a couple palettes this year, I'm not gonna lie. And I find that I don't think the palettes are a waste of money, because I think the palettes are pretty much a way to get, you know, a ton of different looks for a condensed cost amount. So I think palettes I invest in because I know that I can always use them. Personally, for me, I really don't see shadows expiring, eyeshadows. A lot of people do say eyeshadows expire, but to me, I don't find that they expire. Unless they're curdling and they're a cream product, then I get it. But if it's not a cream product and it's powder, I really don't think they would expire. And I've never had that problem with my eyeshadow palettes in the past. So I think that they're pretty much a staple in my particular stash, because I can have a ton of palettes and do a ton of looks but not worry about them expiring. They do, I know that they do have like an not an expiration date, but they have that little canister at the back saying, you know, good for 12 months, good for 24 months. But you know, if they're powder eyeshadows, they don't really go bad in my experience that I've had a couple, you know, for 2 or 3 years. So yeah, I think my main focus for 2016 is more so cream products opposed to powder products. Just because cream products do go bad, like liquid foundations do go bad. They will separate. I've seen it happen. So I think that's going to be my main focus for 2016, is to kind of bring down my cream makeup products and, maybe bring down my lipstick collection just a tad. Because I do have a quite a large lipstick collection. It's not as large as some other YouTubers out there, but I think it's a bit large for me. So I think we're gonna try and kind of bring it down. I'm gonna try my best. I don't know if it'll go down, but I'm gonna try. I'm not really worried about my lipstick products because I don't have a huge amount. But I have a good variety for me to change up my look whenever I want to. So my cream products for next year is what I'm going to be focusing on. My cream foundations, my concealers, that type of stuff. I'm also going to be focusing on bringing down my perfume stash and bringing down my hair care stash, because I have way too much hair care stash. And I want to also bring down my body stash, my body care stash, like body lotions, body washes. I want to also bring down my hair products out of the shower stash. That stuff and my face cleansers I also want to bring down. So I think those are going to be my top. My cream makeup products, my concealers, my foundations, my body care, my hair care in and out of the shower, and my face cleansers I want to bring down as well. So those are going to be my top 5 categories I'm going to focus on next year, because I think those are the biggest right now that I need to kind of bring down a bit. So yeah, this was quite a long video. I'm sorry, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope I've inspired you. If you have a huge ass collection that you want to kind of, you know, decrease a bit to not make it as cluttery in your house, then by all means, you are welcome to join me in my 2016 project pan. I'm going to do a separate video on my 2016 project pan and show you guys in depth of what I'm going to focus on in that particular year project. But until then, I thank you all for watching. Thanks so much for watching this with me. Well, thank you all for joining me, and I hope you guys all have a great day, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, everybody.